just got down here. I was out at the burrow pit for a while, but the grass is just up too high around in the water. Got one already. First cast on the spinnerbait. That's odd. What have we got here? Little micro bass on that big old spinnerbait. Like double hooked. Alright, thanks for biting, buddy. I had another one right there. I hit it. Wasn't a very big one though. A little micro bass, I think. I'm gonna get over this way a little bit. nice day out, kind of a nasty day out. Just waiting for the storm to roll in and I'll leave. Throw out a weight in a Cinco. See what happens here. In his mouth. Might have been a little bluegill or something. There he goes again though. Oh no, maybe I have one. Oh, I have one. I didn't think I had one on there. Okay. Like I said. You're just kind of sitting there holding on to it, I guess. Now, come on, before you knock yourself off. All right, there you go. Okay. You see, this worm is kind of beat up here. I've used it. Used it a few times already. And sometimes when you use them a few times, they wear out on you, but this one has, it's a yum dinger, it's a green and purple flake, green pumpkin and purple flake, and I'm just trying to use it until I can't use it no more, that's all. Get the most out of it I can. Big one of the day so far, and he's been caught before. Looks like they're about in the same place. Right, there we are. Yeah, that's a good one. One probably be scoreable. We were on the Bass Pro Tour. And this thing is about had it. Look how beat up that thing is. All I'm really doing is watching my line. If my line starts to move, then I know I might have a fish. Like right there. Oh. And he actually just took the worm. Oh my goodness. Took all but just a little piece of it. He ripped it right off of there. Alright, so what have we got to work with here? I'll put some in my pocket, I thought. I just looked there. I guess these I haven't opened yet. That one. Alright, let's try this blue and see how it goes. It's actually one of my daughters that I had in my tackle bag. Like a June bug, I believe. Wind's picking up. Biting a little bit. Come here. Not really a micro bass, not really a big bass. Oh man. Ooh, they hurt when I lifted my shoulder, my arm up like that though. Oh my goodness. Problem with my shoulder here lately. I don't know what it is. Thank you. Nothing. I don't think it would do me any good to fish there, honestly. Small to get it in his mouth. Probably a bluegill pecking at it or something. See it if there is. There's so much junk in there. This one I might want to use. Guessing the one I wanted to use is carrying the other box behind this one. I guess I'll open it up and look and see if I can find it. I'm sure I can. It's all this mess. try this now and see how this works for us. So far, nothing. It doesn't mean it won't, it just means it hasn't. Got one right there, got a little big though. First one on the lipless. Oh, I had the first one on the lipless. Yep, you'll have that sometimes. You will have that sometimes. So we're going to move. See if my shoulder will let me move. I do. I want to fish this worm there a little bit more. Maybe I should cut some decent fish on it. Moved a little bit. Just so you guys know, when you see my videos, they've got a watermark on them. This is Power Director. That's one of the disadvantages of using free software. Buying editing software is not in my budget. So, you know, I just use what I can use. I'm not in this channel to make money. I'm in this channel to have fun and share what I do with people. So, you know, when you look at my videos and you see that watermark, I don't really think it should take away from the enjoyment of the video or be reason for anybody to put a comment up there that's kind of rude like I've had in the past. And that's okay. When people do that, I just hide them from the channel. It was really funny too, because I had some gentleman jump on a comment and say, you know, I had a great video, but he was talking about, you know, my tags and stuff like that. A bite here. Probably just a bluegill or something. Not big enough to get a hold of it. But anyway, yeah, I actually got him. I had him. Anyway, I checked out his profile page, and he didn't even have a subscriber yet. And he was supposed to be like some marketing engineer. And I'll tell you right now, guys, if I were going to go with a marketing engineer, it would be somebody like Robert Benjamin or somebody like that got a few thousand subscribers behind their name. I'm not going to have nobody, and nobody just look at my channel and say, you know, you need to do this and you need to do that. Starting to feel a raindrop every now and then. Yeah, it looks like it too. Yeah, I'm really not too worried about the rain. I don't want any lightning. Right, and there's a fish. I don't know how big he is, but he's not real big. What I'm using is just a weightless Yum Dinger. I never have been a big fan of weights, even though last year it netted me some of my biggest fish. But this Texas rig. One of these big bluegills get a hold of it, so I can show you the size of the bluegills in here. That one, by golly. Oh, I had that one anyway. I felt like a pretty decent one too. Or it could have been hung up on a limb down there, but I'm kind of thinking it was a good sized bluegill. About a willow tree. Thank you. be right back here. I'm glad I didn't pack up and leave. The rain stopped already. Sometimes the bluegill will try to get something like this in their mouth and they can't do it. Some big bluegill in here, I know that. Gonna switch off here pretty soon to that lipless. Oh man, he took off with that. What happened? running with that. See if we can do that again. I'm starting to feel rain again. I don't have one on the hall. Alright, but I'm gonna go to my lipless. If this is the first time watching the channel or you're new to the channel, these are the kind of baits that I like throwing. These are the lipless crankbaits. This one actually came from Academy. Paid $3.49 for it. It's the bluegill pattern. And it's netted me some nice fish. A 4 pound 15 ounce trout, 3 pound channel cat. It's got some nice ones. It doesn't mean it'll do so today, but the bugs are so bad in this particular spot. We got one right there. Nah, not a bad one either. Yeah, come on. No, come on. He's barely hooked. Oh. Come on, you can knock yourself out. They're not a bad fish on the lipless. There you are. Get back in there. Yeah. That works. That works. If we can do that again. There's another one. Well, he's a bit bigger, I think. Maybe. What? Oh, he came off. I wonder if I found a school of them there or something. Well, he was fighting a little bit. I don't think he was 2 pounds, but he could have been. Yeah, again, they're not the biggest things in the world, but they're not bad little bass either. It could have been the one I caught earlier. Got that blood in his mouth there. Yeah. There you are, buddy. things here. Oh, I have one right there. hole in my bag and bring it down this way. Following there, I think. Not that time though. I came down here to get my bag, take it up there to the other end. I figured I'd fish for a few minutes. I'll just carry it. I took a bunch of stuff out of it to lower some weight, but really didn't help that much. Took a lot of soft plastics out of it that I don't need anymore, don't use anymore. Spot right up here. I'm gonna stand in for a minute. Standing out on that rock. Got some decent fish today, nothing really big, but a couple of them are kind of small. Surprised there's nothing got on it here so far. And usually right up through here is where I catch some decent ones too. Here again, not a monster, but let me get some line out here on him. Not a monster, but not a small one either. There we go. Here we go, little buddy. this should work down here. Really should.
Got one.
Well, he don't like coming out either.
Come here, buddy. Get out of that brush.
Alright. Looks like the big one of the day right here. You're still not real big, but you're not real little either. Thanks, buddy. Weightless yum dinger. Well, even a fighter. Thought for sure I had him. What he was after. Temperature's dropping. Oh, they ain't going nowhere. Oh, you're decent too. Come here, come here.
a little better too. By golly. I'm gonna say you're pushing that 2 pound mark, so I think after I get you off of this hook, which you're hooked pretty good, I'll put you on a scale. Scale's over here in my bag. Shoot about close to 1 pound and 3/4, maybe even 2. Now you're only 1 pound and 1/4, but my, you feel bigger. All right, maybe that's because the only thing I've been catching is dinks. All right, buddy, thanks for biting. See, right now my battery's getting low and I don't have any batteries with me for this, so I'll have to change it when I get home. Hockey ball. a big one. Oh. Water mouth. Yeah, there you are. Decent sized water mouth. Those frisky little critters. They'll tell you to warm up, that's for sure. Watching those clouds back there. Too much about getting too far out there because there's all kinds of cover right here that I can catch fish with. Okay. Well, I guess I'll go back over here to one of the benches. No. That don't look too good. Big one, but